Hello, my beautiful NTNP. So guys, today I'm doing a requested video from Precious. She's my friend, she's my sister, she's also my subscriber. She asked me to do something about chebe, but because it's long, I've not done any video about butter mix, so I choose to do it like a creamy form. So this is how chebe looks like. For those of you that haven't seen chebe for the first time, even me, this is my first time seeing this chebe powder, how it looks. So now I'm going to just see the smell, because I can feel some strong odor coming out before I bring it out from the package. So guys, this is how it looks. It's this brownish, you know. That's according to the ingredients. There are different herbs or seed, I don't know what it is, mixed together and blended, you know, for faster hair growth. So guys, it also had this very strong smell. This smell, it's like something that I know in Nigeria, but I can't really figure it out for now. So whatever. So this is how it looks. It's just like a powder. So guys, now I'm going ahead to, you know, infuse my chebe powder with my preference oil. So each oil, I will be needing 3 spoons. So if you want to also infuse yours, you can use your preference oil. You can go ahead, do as I'm doing. So it's just based on you. So now I will infuse the chebe powder first with my oil. Why? Because butter are very thick to infuse anything. So I'm going to infuse it with the liquid, which is the oil, first before adding my butter. So now I will allow it to stay for 30 minutes, because when it starts to infuse, you will see some foaming, like a bubble, something bubbling out like so. So this is how you will know that the oil is infused, but you allow it to infuse for 30 minutes before you can start with any other thing you want to do. Now it has infused for 30 minutes. So I'm just giving it a stir. You can see the bubbling of the oil has stopped. So I'm just going to just give it a stir and just explain something to you guys now. So before I start anything, let me just explain something about the residue inside this oil, which is the chebe powder. So in this place, if you want to sieve it to remove the residue, you are free to do that. But as for me, I'm not going to do so, and I will explain why. I don't know if you guys could remember this hemp seed, hemp or a pomade that we do use those days for hair growth and on our hair. And it has this hemp seed inside the pomade. Okay, so I'm just looking at this chebe form of butter or cream or oil as the same as the hemp seed pomade. So they do leave some seeds of this hemp inside the pomade because it helps to stimulate our scalp and hair follicle for faster hair growth. And remember guys, this hemp seed does stay in your hair, but it doesn't cause build up, it doesn't cause anything to your scalp. Immediately you wash your hair, when you want to wash your hair, it will go off. So the same thing I'm thinking about this chebe as well. I believe, because I'm not going to use everything just one day, so I'm going to use it let me say once a week, okay, or I don't know, but it's not going to leave its residue in my hair in that form, okay, because using it once a week will not leave the whole amount of products you are doing now in your hair. No, it's going to be gradually that you're going to use this butter. And apart from that, you will wash your hair, let me say twice a week, once a month. I mean, you are going to apply maybe twice a month. So just the way I'm saying about myself, I might apply mine every day, but I've even tested it after I finish doing it. I found that the residue is not that irritative. So this is the reason why I just thought of this. The hemp seed, they are big, okay, and they do stay in our hair, but they never cause any buildup, okay guys. So this is my reason why I'm going to leave my everything. I'm going to do everything together without selfing anything, okay. So with all this being said, I just want to explain that if you find it useful, you can do yours as well. If not, you can sieve yours. So I'm going to go ahead now adding my butter parts to the oil. I call that one full huge spoon, 2 spoon when it's melt of coconut oil. So now I'm going to add my palm kernel oil, which my mother brought for me. I'll be using this palm kernel oil, which for those of you that has been following me from the beginning, you will remember this oil. So this is still the oil, it doesn't expire, okay. We use it to treat our baby in Nigeria when they have cough, when they have to massage their body. It helps their hair to grow. They need to rub their hair. It helps their hair to thick. It never cause breakage, okay. I even love this more than coconut oil. I said it in one of my videos some time ago. So after that, now I'm just going to give it a stir, you know, to just allow it to melt a little bit. Then I go ahead, after washing my hands, I will add my shea butter, 1 huge spoon of shea butter. So then I will also add my beeswax, which I used to say I love beeswax when I'm doing anything butter cream, because it helps to lock moisture to my hair, my own type of hair. I love it anyway. If I do anything creamy without beeswax, I found that creamy, that butter creamy, doesn't maintain my the moisture in my hair that long. So after then everything has met out, I'm going to put off my flame and set it aside before I start working it out in the other section. So now guys, as you can see, that is the residue that I'm saying. I'm going to leave everything inside this butter. So you are going to mix gradually. I put it in the fridge. I bring it out now because my camera went off. My battery was dead. I have to, charge it and start all over again. So now I kept it in the fridge for 15 minutes because it was still hot. Now it's warm a little bit, it's coming down. So I'm adding my essential oil, my usual tea tree, lemon, lavender. This time I add also the last one I used last time. So I just stir it a little bit. I kept it back in the fridge again for another 15 minutes, then I bring it out again, okay. So I'm still going to work it out now by starts, whisking. So guys, I'm not going to do that wiping, foam. I'm going to mix it because I want it to come, because most times the one I wipe, when you wipe products, they come in some, at times I don't like how they come. In this form, I like it to come that creamy, everything will be creamy, okay. So now I kept in the fridge again for another 5 minutes. I bring it out. So this is the final mix I'm going to do before I put it into my my jar or wherever I'm going to keep it. So now let me use this opportunity to just say for those of you that just clicked to my channel for the first time, I hope you love this video, if not this one, any other one. So I've put some into my jar. Now I'm going to pour this many one into my other jars. This is how it's the consistency is. It's fluid now, but when it's cool down, it's going to come. When you just take it, it's going to come that creamy. Don't worry, when you do yours, you are going to understand what I'm trying to say. So guys, as I was saying, if you don't, maybe it's not this video that you like to see, check to my playlist. You will find a lot of video over there by clicking down to where I write no trick natural product, or to the red strips that says subscribe. And please help me to share this video, like with the like button. If you've not subscribed, subscribe. And I wish you all the best. And may God bless you for, you know, tuning to my channel for the first time, watching my video, share and support me. God Almighty will bless all of you in Jesus Christ's name. Bye-bye.